you, ma'am.
Hey, guys.
Welcome back to Plots with a Twist,
where we discuss books,
amongst other things. And today, it's the end of the year. Let's get into some of the things.
2020 is over, y'all.
Yeah.
Finally.
Yeah. Finally, right? So we thought we'd come with a video discussing some of the books that we wish we read in the year 2020 and some that we wish we didn't. So
yeah, we could have kept those.
Let's get into it. All right, so which one you want to start with? Which books we wish we read or
books? Let's do the books we wish we had read this year.
Okay, you want to go first?
Okay, I'll go first. So a book that I wish I had gotten to this year is Six of Crows by Leigh Bardugo.
Mm-hmm.
So, girl, I've been trying to read this book, and I own the book and everything, and it was on my list for a while, but then I just got behind and need to catch up. And it's just fallen to the wayside. But since I own it, I will definitely try to read it in the near future, hopefully in 2021. But that is definitely a book that I had planned on reading this year and didn't get a chance to, and I wish I did. What you got?
I don't recall the author right now, but of course I'll link it or it'll be right here. So one book I wish I read within 2020 is Akita Witch. So I had that on hold, got it and everything. And I just ran, same thing, like I ran out of time. I had heard great things about it. I haven't really read too many, like I read Harry Potter, I read Children of Blood and Bone, but I haven't really read too many books that discuss or fantasy based books that like go into witchcraft and wizardry besides those. And I saw a few that came out this year and I really wanted, well, Akita Witch came out a few years ago, but I really wanted to get more kind of like some of those, the dark arts. Because I used to love, like I used to think I was a witch.
Oh my God.
Yes. Like I used to love the craft growing up because like I was like, oh, light as a feather, stiff as a
wood. Oh my God.
But yeah, I really wanted to read that this year, but I didn't. So hopefully maybe I'll get to it next year. We'll see. So that's Akita Witch.
Okay, so another Akata book.
Did I say it right? Good. Y'all know we don't know how to talk.
Right. So another book that I wish I had read this year is a book, another book that we've mentioned a lot on this channel and that Kristen actually read, another book she's read, which is City of Girls by Elizabeth Gilbert. And the tea is, guys, I got it available as an Audible book and still didn't get to it because I had the time. So that's a book that I plan on reading eventually in my lifetime, but I definitely had wanted to get to it this year, but didn't happen, didn't make the cut. I'm gonna get to it eventually though, so not worried.
All right, so for me, the next book, again, on the same vein as Akata Witch. Again, another book that, this one came out this year, earlier this year, it was a young adult book. It's called The Year of Witching by Alexis Henderson. Oh, and again, I wanted to get another book that dove into witchcraft and told a compelling story about, you know, typically most of them have, you know, female leads, except Harry Potter. But so I really wanted to try that, and I saw that it was nominated, I think, for some Goodread awards and everything. So I was like, oh, I missed out. Got that one on hold, ran out of time. And yeah, so hopefully, maybe, we'll see. It can roll over to next year, but that's The Year of Witching by Alexis Henderson.
So much witchcraft on your list.
I know. It's actually a few. I got a lot of fantasy books I wanted to get to. I feel like I enjoy fantasy, but I haven't read a lot of fantasy.
You definitely enjoy fantasy, though.
I enjoy the escapism of it. Not like it being attached to something I can actually be involved in.
Yeah. So for me, I'll say this is like, I grouped it in as under author, but Tana French books. Like, such as The Witch, I wanted to read that, and I think that's a series too, right?
That's a separate one. So yes. I think after her first six, those are all kind of like separate books.
So yeah, that in particular I want to read. But yeah, I just didn't get to any Tana French this year, and I am disgusted with myself because that was my girl. Like, I just really need to get, definitely next year, I'm at least reading, I want to finish the Dublin Murder Squad series next year, hopefully, but I at least have to get one or two Tana French in there. But yeah, so I didn't get to read any of her books this year, and I'm really disappointed in myself about that. But it's okay, she's on the list forever. So.
I'm with you because I wanted to read the books, I wanted to watch the show, like everything.
Oh, yeah, we still haven't, yeah.
We'll get to it. That's a lot to do. We are only two people. It's a lot. All right. So my last one under books I meant to read or wished I read this year was one that I mentioned in our as a pinky promise in our five finger tag was The Night Circus by Aaron Mortensen.
Oh, I remember that because it has a cool cover. I can picture the book in my head right now.
It was I said her name wrong. Aaron Morgenstern. That was like a book I continue to see everywhere, a book a lot of people have said they have enjoyed. Some people did say kind of like they could leave it, but most of the people who've like responded or talked about that book that I've seen has thoroughly enjoyed it. She also came out with another one this year, The Sealess Witch. Another witch book I need to get into. I think it's called The Sealess Witch. Or no, it's called The Starless Sea. I wanted it to be a witch. And I'm all Sealess Witch. That don't even sound right. But I promised that I would try to finish that this year or start that this year, and I didn't. And I just really wish I did because it would be one, another book off my belt. And then two, I just, like I said, I want to get involved in more fiction this year. I mean, not more fiction, more fantasy this year.
Yeah.
And I stuck to a lot more like fiction, heartwarming, a few, like, yeah, I'm with you. Next year, I'm getting back to my roots. I'm getting to them thrillers.
Yes.
I'm getting to them fantasy books and a sprinkle of other stuff.
Just a sprinkle.
So that's my last one for wish I read this year. So let's get into some of the books we wish we did.
Yeah.
All right. So what's your first one?
So first one I'll go with is one that I've talked about before here, so I'm not going to spend too much time on it, but just going back and looking at the books that I really didn't care for that I read this year. Y'all heard me dump on this book before, and it's called Living in the Light by Shakti Gawain. Don't read it. No, I'm not gonna say don't read it, but
it was just a waste of time.
Very much a repetition of her earlier work, and it had a lot of typos. It might have just been the edition that I had, but it wasn't my favorite at all this year. So,
all right. So, wish I didn't read The Boy from the Woods by Harlan Coben.
You like Harlan Coben?
I don't mind him. I don't know him. Oh. You know, but. That was my first book by him that I read, and he has a ton of books.
Yeah.
But just my first experience with his writing so late in his career, I'm like thinking I'm about to get all the goods. And that book for me was mediocre. I could have left it where it was. I let, you know, the hype of it kind of influence my decision to read it. And yeah, it was nothing really redeeming about it for me. Except for it was a story, you know? But, so, yeah, I just wish I didn't take the time to invest or not invest in that one. Maybe I'll try another one by him, but he's kind of on my list.
Right,
so
you not rush into it.
Yeah.
Okay, so one for me that I read recently and didn't too much care for is Luster by
Raven Leilani,
because I did not know the author's name. So I recently listened to that as audiobook, and Kristen already told me that it was a little bit difficult and triggering to listen to. And I would have to agree. I could have done without it. Kristen had told me like earlier that people have compared it to Queenie, like a version of Queenie, but it wasn't. Y'all know I loved Queenie. I enjoyed that book a lot, and I feel like it wasn't that. It was more sad. It wasn't funny. Like how Queenie
was. It was like the same kind of issues,
yeah,
deep-rooted issues, maybe similar. I'm not gonna say the same, similar deep-rooted issues, but yeah, Queenie had a more humorous approach.
It's described as a dark comedy, but I didn't find myself laughing at it. It didn't give me that, so just really didn't. And the other stuff that I was reading around the time too. I was just like, this is too much on top of too much, like emotionally. So I just didn't enjoy it, and I could have definitely swapped that out this year for something else. So that was Luster by Raven Leilani. But I would read if she has other books or she comes out with something else, I would read it. Like,
yeah, her writing was good. That's why I said it was a little literary too.
Yeah,
but just the story, it was kind of, like I said, odd. It was just really weird and like sad.
It was very sad.
But yeah, I'm with you on that. But my second one I wish I did not read. I've said this before. Darling Rose Gold by Stephanie Warble. I left that story with a bad taste in my mouth. Like, it did not feel good to read. Like, there are certain stories, like, I don't care if it has a happy ending or, you know, or just things like that. Like, that doesn't really bother me with books. Mm-hmm. Ideally, of course, I'd like a happy ending. But, like, if I can understand the progression and why the ending was the way it was, I'm okay with it being like, oh, that's sad. But this one supposedly had kind of like a happy ending. And you couldn't even tell. Like, you just felt really, like, I don't know, it was just a really off-putting book. Just the plot, the narrative of it, I just didn't real, I didn't feel good reading it, and I didn't feel good walking away from it. So that's Darling Rose Gold. Wish I didn't read it.
Okay, so last one for me is another book that I mentioned on here, and not that I didn't like, not that it was a bad book, but I just could have done without reading it, such as Luster, same as Luster, which is Call Me By Your Name by,
what's his name?
Don't Give Me the Lion.
Andre.
Something. Andre Lee. No.
Y'all, I got a Kindle for Black Friday.
Look it up real quick.
Andre
Ackerman. Yeah, or something like that. I knew it. So, yeah, that book, I had mentioned it in our, like, most disappointing reads, and that was disappointing because I feel like it was very much hyped up, especially even after the movie. People just, you know, you see the book. Even till this day, I feel like people talk about it a lot, and it's just one of those cult classics, if you will. But, yeah, it didn't take me like that, so. And I've already talked about it in that most disappointing reads video, which we'll link somewhere so you guys can see that if you haven't already. But I could have done without it this year. I could have swapped that out for definitely could have swapped it out for a Tana French. Oh,
for a Tana French or Six of Crows.
You know, like, it was just like, could have done without it. So yeah, that was my list as far as like what I didn't read. And Kristen read more books than me this year, so she had more to choose from.
All right, so the last book I wish, this one is kind of, because it was right in the middle, I wanted to mention something that I hadn't mentioned before. But it was kind of gave me the same feeling that I had as far as Darling Rose go, and that's You Are Not Alone by Sarah Pickenin and Greer Hendricks, I believe, if I'm saying that right, saying their names right. But so we read The Wife Between Us, and so I saw that they had, that was their most recent one, You Are Not Alone. So I went ahead and put it on hold, listened to it, and it's the same kind of vibe as, like, there's no rhyme or reason to why this particular, like, protagonist is being kind of isolated and picked on. Mm-hmm. So I just didn't feel like the plot or the actions that happened throughout the plot were warranted. And I just didn't feel like I was able to really connect with the story because of that. So not to say I wouldn't have ever read it. I think it was probably just the timing of me trying to read, like, really substantial books, and that one was, like, mixed in there, and it's like, Why are you here? But maybe if I read that later, not to say it would have resonated with me, but it didn't make a good use of my time. If that's the best way to say it. So that's You Are Not Alone. Like, I'm not mad I read it, but I kind of wish I did.
Right.
Like, especially back to back with, I preferred The Wife Between Us, and then that one was, like,
yeah,
not on par. So, yeah, so that's pretty much it. So, let us know some books that you wish that you read this year, or some books that you wish you didn't.
Yeah.
Engage. Let us know if some of the books we mentioned here are worth it or not. Because if I got something that I mentioned that y'all say don't even try, I'm going to be like, okay, cool.
I feel like all mine are good picks for next year or for the future.
Yeah. So like this video, subscribe, ring the bell, and we will be back next time. Have a happy new year.
Happy new year, guys.
Bye.